welcome to Dude RV. Hey, I sure appreciate you stopping by. Today, we're going to be climbing up into the Appalachian Mountains, and we're going to visit the Pizgah National Forest and spend a couple of nights camped at Lake Powhatan. Arrived Lake Powhatan, Lake Powhatan National Forest Campground, Pizgah National Forest. Man, what a cool site! What a cool campground. We made it through the Appalachian Mountains without any panic attacks. So we're happy to, no drama until we got here. And then I realized I booked a site without any power, and I have to have a CPAP machine. So, but they were very cordial at the front gate and helped us get into a site with power. It is site number 49. And when I first rolled up here, I'm like, oh man, I don't think that's gonna work. Cause it's a slope. I'm like, holy cow. But after I got out, and I mean, this is a full hookup site. So we're very, very fortunate. Although I rarely ever connect sewer, I just use the dump station on the way out. Labor saver. Same effort either way. But let's talk about the site. It is an asphalt pad, and it's pretty side to side. It's pretty good. And once you get up on top of the hill, front to back's not too bad. I did have to put three layers of blocks in, and then the leveling jack lifted the front wheels to just about that high. As I said, it's a full connection, water, sewer, and power. Lots of beautiful shade tree. And it's very pleasant. I don't know what the temperature is, but it's not bad at all. It sure isn't hot like Texas. We have a concrete and wood picnic table. But be careful, you might get some splinters in your butt. We've got a fire ring and the ubiquitous lantern hook. There are bears here because we're in the Pizgah National Forest. There's black bears. And so the gentleman at the front gate said, be bear aware. Don't leave food out. Don't leave ice chests out. Otherwise, you'll have an issue. All right. Going to grab some lunch and then we're going to go see some stuff. And I'm going to have to do it in the white truck because Little Red, I'm pretty sure, is dead. I'm gonna tinker with Little Red this afternoon after we see some stuff, and I'll see if I can get her back on the road. I don't know. We'll see. All right. Stay tuned. Lake Powhatan Campground, Pizgah Forest, has got, I mean, you don't even have to own your own tent. This one is ADA accessible. You can rent this. They don't have yurts. They have canvas tents. Check it out. Complete with linen. Of course, it looks like somebody has just slept in that. Got a small cot on the side. That's pretty dang cool. So you don't even have to have a tent if you want to come out here and get that camping experience. Great way to kind of try it before you buy it. They've got quite a few of them too. And I did some research on this campsite campground, and I didn't even know they had the tents. Let's take a look at this one, see if it's any different. It looks like it comes, it includes a bundle of firewood. You see, that one's made up. It's got power. It's a solar generator, not a solar generator, but just a Yeti power plant. Coffee maker, fan. Ice chest, queen size bed, and a cot. And bug screen. How about that? That's pretty cool. Lake Powhatan, got you covered. All right, let's go see some more stuff. Lake Powhatan, Pizgah National Forest, North Carolina. Check this out. How cool is that? They got this beautiful little beach. Unfortunately, it's not exactly ADA friendly. There's a flight of stairs that you have to go down. And if I had a scooter, there may be, I don't know. I'll explore, but it looks like that there actually may be a trail down. There's a fishing area over there that we'll have to see if we can get to. But no scooter means I'll have to hobble over there. It looks like maybe you're supposed to launch your kayak here too. I don't know. It says no flotation devices. It doesn't say anything about kayaks. Huh. I bet that goes back around to the campsite. All right. Let's go see some stuff. All right. We have made it to the other side. Okay. Made it to the other side of the little lake. There's a fishing dock. Brook trout, rainbow trout, brown trout. Cool! Might have to break out some fishing gear. Man, what a fishing dock this is. There you go. There is a picturesque scene, if ever there was one. I need to get the time lapse set up on this. Hopefully, no one walks off with the camera. Oh. Let's do it. Let's go see some more stuff. Well, I haven't figured out how to get down below the dam, but I figured out how to get above the dam. Surely there would be a trail somewhere. I can't be the only one that wants to see it.
I'm inside this cage covered in poison ivy.
I'm free! Let's go see some more stuff! Where am I? I'm in the Pizgah National Forest. Lake Powhatan. I don't know if this is the Lake Powhatan Dam or not.
I was up there. This is pretty cool, literally.
Water makes it feel very nice down here. All right, let's go see some more stuff. What's up, Goose? Even the geese like it here. And it's quiet here.
I can hardly even hear the air conditioner next door thanks to the wind and the trees.
Hard to believe we're only 10 minutes from suburbia. Of course, that's the advantage of being in the mountains. More to come. Well, good morning. Where are we? Lake Powhatan, Lake Powhatan Campground, Pizgah National Forest, North Carolina. Such a beautiful place. With the exception of the air conditioner next door, all you can hear are birds singing. Beautiful. Well, 2 days ago I had Little Red develop some serious mobility problems. So for those of you who haven't been following along, Little Red is the high-speed mobility scooter that I use to create virtual tours of campgrounds. Not most likely Little Red is not going to be back. I think I can get Little Red running again, just not while we're traveling. Have to wait till we get back to home base. I'm pretty sure it's brushes in the motor or something. And that's not the kind of repair that I could do on the fly, at least with the current, well, availability of parts will be first and foremost. So I've been thinking, I've got an alternate plan, and we'll be trying that here at this campground. And I'll show you that setup when I get ready to do it. It's still early. Just sitting here enjoying the bird song. So there's not a whole lot of, as far as connectivity goes in this campground, it's very spotty. Yesterday we had some T-Mobile data and we're roaming on the Verizon phone network. No data there. Neither AT&T or Verizon had connectivity, but T-Mobile was spotty during the afternoon. Right now, no data. We got no G's. Well, stay tuned. I'll see what else we can find to do. Lake Powhatan Campground. Beautiful place. We've got a number. Lake Powhatan. What am I trying to say? Lake Powhatan Campground has a number of really nice RV sites with full connection. This is a double. So you can get two RVs traveling in tandem in here. $74 per night. And they only rent it as a double. There are several large motorhomes in here with us. But then on the other side of that coin, there's a lot of sites where you'll have a hard time getting level, such as this one. If you have a motorhome, you're not going to get level in that because it runs downhill so far. You have to put a whole lot of blocks under your back wheels. And then this one, it's not too bad. Oh, look at the squirrel, chipmunk. That'll drive the ratty pack crazy. Have been, as a matter of fact. They don't know what to do with that. Well, this is a full connection. You'll have a hard time getting level on this. You had to block up your front tires. The trailer, it wouldn't be so bad. And you get over into the tent camping loop, and the sights are even more extreme. So my recommendation is to call the front gate and ask about site, what sites would be better, and you'll be able to watch the virtual tour that I'm going to create that'll give you some insight. Today's video is sponsored by campgroundviews.com. Cutting edge technology in trip planning for your RV trip. You want to know what that site's going to look like? They have got you covered with 360 degree views of every campsite. They currently are focusing on recreation.gov campsites. They have completed all of the West Coast and are in the process of getting all of the East Coast campsites, and then they'll be moving into the Central United States. They have an early bird special that I'm taking advantage of, and I recommend that you check it out and see if it fits with your budget as well, because this technology is what we RVers have been dying for. We'll be able to see exactly what the sites look like. No surprises when we get there because of those 360-degree views. So my hat's off to campgroundviews.com. The link is in the description below. I encourage you to go check out what they're doing and see if it's right for you. All right, let's go back to what we were doing.
Let's go see what else we can get into.
Well, we're at Lake Powhatan in the Pizgah National Forest, and we're done here. I'm gonna go ahead and close this out this evening. The sun is setting. There's a cold front blowing through, and apparently it's an unusual cold front for this area for this time of year. And there's thunderstorms scheduled for tonight and in the morning, and who knows what the morning will bring. So I'm gonna close out this video right here to give you a summary of Lake Powhatan. I like it. I really like this campground. This is a beautiful campground. The one exception is they've changed the flight path for the airport, and now we have airplanes flying over us. But other than that, this park is beautiful. It's quiet. There's not a whole lot of stuff. There's the lake, swimming and fishing. And there's mountain biking or hiking. And if you're into hiking and mountain biking, this is a place. I mean, there's trails all through these woods. A number of trailheads. And it's just like nonstop local cyclists all over the place. I didn't do any fishing. We were not really here long enough to make it to be able to for me to justify getting a fishing license with a trout tag. Maybe on another trip, I'll plan on a longer visit and see about catching some trout. The campsite that we have is fantastic. The bathrooms are clean. You have individual rooms for the shower and the bathroom. Totally separate, so it's not a communal kind of thing. Yappy's on mission. She's cleaning up camp. Anyway, we're done here. I highly recommend you come pay a visit. This would be both a fantastic waypoint if you're traveling on 40 in either direction. It would also be a fantastic destination because you're right here at Asheville, and there's a number of great things like the Biltmore to see in Asheville, North Carolina. If this is your first visit to Dude RV, I'd be honored if you'd consider clicking on the subscribe button. And for those, and remember, hit that bell as well. That way you'll never miss another episode of Dude RV. And for those of you who have been following along, man, I appreciate that. That's why I get to see all of these great places. Thank you for that opportunity. That's why I do what I do. And for my patrons, I don't have a cover. You guys rock. All right, y'all come back now, you hear?